Hello, beautiful humans. Thank you so much for joining me for another video. As always, I'm so grateful and so excited that you are here with me today in today's video. We're gonna talk about lots of stuff today, so bear with me. If you are a returning member of our community, then welcome back. Thank you so much for your patience, for joining me today. And if you are new to my channel, then welcome. It's so great to meet you. My name is Bailey M. Bain. I am a yoga and meditation instructor as well as a fellow endo warrior goddess. I was diagnosed with endometriosis back in April of 2021. Ever since then, I have been on my channel documenting my journey with my symptoms, my surgery, my recovery, and my healing journey. So I am working on healing without hormones, and if that sounds like something that you are interested in, then please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, join our community. I post videos 3 times a week, and I'm laughing when I say that because if you are a returning community member on my channel, then you know I came back on in early December and made a video welcoming myself back to the channel and saying, oh yeah, I'm gonna continue posting videos 3 times a week in December, and I think I kind of took November off too, and things have just been really, really crazy since I started substitute teaching full-time at the middle school. I'm in Michigan, I'm based in Michigan, and we had a shooting about 30 minutes away from our house, from our school district in Michigan the week after Thanksgiving, and ever since then things have just been really traumatic and kind of up in the air and stressful for everyone, and so thank you so much for your patience with me as I continue to get back into the swing of things. It's the new year. I am posting this on January 2nd, and yes, welcome to 2022. I saw a meme that's like, don't touch anything, just walk quietly, put your hands in your pockets, and kind of just keep your head down. And we'll hope for a good year in 2022. But I wanted to, in today's video, share a update with you on my health because lots of things have been going on since we last spoke. And I wanted to kind of first talk you through my New Year's intention for 2022. A huge thank you goes out to Rachel Braithen at Yoga Girl. Every year she posts this beautiful podcast on the Yoga Girl podcast, Conversations from the Heart. And it goes into like really recapping the year and putting a pretty little bow on what happened last year, or maybe a not so pretty bow, but really closing out the year in a mindful and intentional way, and then starting off the new year with these New Year's intentions. And so my New Year's intentions, after going through this huge, I think everything together, it took me probably about 4 hours to come up with all of these things, and I've narrowed my New Year's intention down into pretty much one affirmation, and that is I am embodied. I had a reading done last year where I was reminded that my journey here on this planet is embodiment, and I think all of my health experiences and all of my health journeys, and I'll get into that here in just a minute, kind of go along with that sense of embodiment and really just embracing my own healing journey and putting myself first, my own self-care, my own self-healing first. And that's what I advocate for. That's what my channel's all about. That's why I'm here. That's my mission on this planet. So my mission for 2022, my intention, is to allow the universe to continue to guide me on my path to embodiment. And so you're going to see me fully embracing that mission throughout this year on my channel. I'm going to be sharing lots more of my healing journeys and getting more into more than just endometriosis, because I have a laundry list of things that I go through and that I deal with, and my routine and my self-care, you know, regimen goes far beyond outside endometriosis. And you know, I'm still learning how to care for my endometriosis as well, and so welcome to that journey, and please feel free to follow along. But yeah, that's where I'm at. That's my New Year's mission, New Year's goal. And so with that, let's get into a health update. That's the reason I'm here. I'll try to make it quick. So, as I mentioned before, I had a laparoscopy in April of 2021 that was to diagnose and remove my endometriosis. That was successful. I was diagnosed with stage 2 endometriosis at the time. They found it on my left ovary, on the back of my uterus, and on some of the ligaments in there. And so, during my laparoscopy, I actually have the pictures, and I will put that up on the screen here in just a minute. During my laparoscopy, my doctor found that my appendix was inflamed, and everything, the way that my appendix looks, it aligns with appendicitis. And so when he was in there doing the surgery, he told me after the fact that he didn't feel my appendix was like an immediate cause for concern, like need to remove it right then and there, that we would just keep an eye on it. And so I have the pictures of it. Kind of going about my business, I brought that up to my primary care physician at that time. But once I healed and was all good from everything from the surgery in April, it was about June that I started a round of really strong antibiotics. And I don't know if you guys can relate at all, but I know that my body doesn't do antibiotics very well. I think that's because of the MTHFR mutation that I have. I had like a whole bunch of different other symptoms that were brought about just because of the antibiotics as a reaction to the antibiotic. Like, I got thrush on my tongue really bad. My tongue turned completely white, and it's just really gross. Anyways, after the round of antibiotics, I was feeling kind of okay. Like, I didn't really have, I had side pain every once in a while on my right side. That's why I brought it up to my doctor then. That's why we did the round of antibiotics then, because it wasn't causing me consistent pain all the time. And so I'm going about my business, start this new job in September, get on board in November as a full-time art teacher, substitute in middle school. And so now December rolls along. And the last few weeks in December, I was feeling that like dull, aching pain in my side. And you know, a lot of things are mindset. So I'm trying not to freak myself out. I would know if my appendix ruptured. That's just something you would pass out, you'd be throwing up, you would know. It's one of those things that you know. So I haven't got to that point yet, knock on wood. But I do have this dull, aching side pain, and my primary care physician told me to, if that starts happening, she gave me a referral for a general surgeon to go talk to them and proceed with having it out. So it took about 6 months, and then I started having that consistent dull aching pain. And so now here I am. I had an appointment in December that I made with the general surgeon that they referred. She referred me to two of them. I always read the reviews on those, because one of them did not have very good reviews. The other one has fantastic reviews, and that's who I'm going with. And I loved my appointment with him. So I met with him, showed him the pictures of my laparoscopy, caught him up to speed, and he said normally we would do like a scan to see if the appendix is inflamed before just going and taking it out. But I trust your doctors. I see right here in the pictures that you brought me that your appendix is inflamed. And so all an extra scan or imaging would do is tell me that your appendix is inflamed, which we already know, so we will just go ahead and take it out. So that was quick and that was easy. He asked me if I had any pre-existing like health conditions or what other things I have going on, and the first thing I said was I have a condition called MTHFR. It's an MTHFR genetic mutation, and not even a lot of doctors know what that is. So when I find a doctor that knows what that is, I'm like, oh, heck yeah. Like, they're on my team, they're on board. Yes, I'm down for that. So I said, I have the MTHFR mutation. Do you know what that is? And he was like, oh yeah, yes, I deal with patients with that all the time. And I'm like, yes, fantastic. And I just looked at him, I said, that's how I know that we are a good match, because not everyone knows what that is. And so the fact that you just even know what that is tells me that I'm in good hands, and that you won't do anything that will cause any harm or damage. So I scheduled and I always mess this word up, laparoscopic, lapar, maybe that's right, I don't know, an appendectomy. So it's going to be kind of just like the laparoscopy I had for my endometriosis, but it's going to be 3 incisions on my right hand side. He said that the healing process will be very, very similar. The incision on the top will be a little bit bigger so that they can pull the appendix actually out of it. And so he said that that top incision will be a little bit more tender than the other ones. But other than that, I should be feeling, you know, somewhat back to normal in the same amount of time that I did with my other surgery. And the only difference really is that this time I'm teaching in a school setting, and so I have to take 2 weeks off of work. And the only reason that it is 2 weeks and not sooner than 2 weeks is because we have a lot of fighting going on at school, and so I have to be ready to be able to break up a middle school fight at any given time. And so I would not be safe breaking up a middle school fight within 2 weeks of having that surgery. And so, yeah, good times in middle school. But yeah, I'm excited. I don't feel as nervous as I did before. I think it was just because that was my first surgery ever at that time, and so fear of the unknown is a huge thing for me. And now that I kind of know what to expect, know what I'm getting myself into, I feel safe. I feel like I'm in great hands. I'm more excited than anything. He mentioned that this should help with a lot of my stomach problems. Obviously, the side pain should go away. And then he even mentioned it might help with some of my endometriosis symptoms, and it might even help with my nausea. I'm not gonna get my hopes up on those last two, but if it does, then I won't complain. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to feeling better, feeling like myself, and getting things figured out before my wedding. We're getting married in September, and I just don't wanna have to, you know, I wanna feel good for all that stuff. I wanna be in my best, most tip-top shape. Every bride wants to be, right? So yeah, that is January 24th. I'll be having my appendectomy, and I will be sure to film and keep you updated. And of course, yeah, that's what I have going on. I have a question though. If any other endometriosis warriors, any endo warriors, any endo warrior goddesses out there, I wonder if any of you also have had your appendix removed by laparoscopy, and what your healing journey was like. Was it similar to your endometriosis recovery? Was it different? How so? Let me know in the comments below. I am just curious about your journeys, and you know, maybe a lot of us have to have that appendix removed anyways because it becomes so damaged from the endometriosis. I'd be curious just what the correlation is. So let me know in the comments below, and that's all I have for you in today's video. I hope that you have a fantastic rest of your day. Much love and grace to each and every single one of you. Thanks for tuning in today's video, and happy healing. Bye. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Follow me on social media for more daily content. And as always, I'll be back every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday with more content.